Let me show you how I made these wild VFX clips all with AI. No After Effects, no fancy designer, just a solid prompt, a reference video, and a little creativity. The tool is called Aleph, Runway's new chat-based video editing model. All you do is upload your video, type in what you want, and boom. The crazy level of VFX is done by AI. In the next few minutes, I'll share some of the best examples and use cases of this tool. So let's dive in. All right, once you're on Runway's homepage, just click here to start a new session. Then click here to upload the video file you want to edit. Right now, you can only edit up to 5 seconds of a clip, so click the trim option and select the part you want to keep. You can also upload a reference image. In my case, I'm using this empty room as the video and this sofa image as the reference. Now simply type in your prompt, just like you would with ChatGPT or any other chat-based AI tool. For example, I'll type, "Place the sofa from the reference image on the floor of this scene. Match the perspective and lighting so it blends naturally with the room. Then hit the generate button, and Aleph will get to work." The process usually takes about 1 to 2 minutes. All right, so here we have the generated video. Let's play it. You can see it did a pretty good job. The sofa is placed on the ground, influenced by the reference image, but it's not the exact same sofa. And that's the thing. The reference image feature in Runway Aleph works differently compared to other tools like Flux or ChatGPT's image models. According to Runway's docs, the image is mainly used to influence colors, styles, lighting, and overall aesthetics. You can't drop the exact subject from the reference image straight into your video. For example, I uploaded a simple image of a solid color, and Aleph immediately understood it. Then it applied that exact color to the walls of the room, and as you can see, it just nailed it. Similarly, you can also provide a reference image for the lighting you want. Then just type a prompt like, "Relight the video using the lighting from this image." Here's the result. You can clearly see the before and after. The lighting in the video is now very close to the reference image I provided. Pretty impressive. And here's another example. I uploaded an anime image as a reference and gave the prompt, "Restyle the video using the style from the image." And again, the result came out really close to the reference. It just nailed the vibe. Now, to be fair, the tool still struggles with high motion or small details. Sometimes you'll get a wonky result like this. But honestly, it's still in a very early stage, and you can only expect it to get better from here. One more thing to keep in mind. By default, all the output videos are 720p. But if you want higher quality, you can upscale them to 4K for just 10 credits. It's not a massive jump, but it does make a subtle improvement in sharpness and detail. So another cool thing you can do is actually change the weather or the time of day in a video. For this test, I used a clip of a van driving through a city that I generated with Kling. Now all I had to do was type a prompt like, "Change the weather to a snowstorm," or "Make it rainy." Same for time. You can just say nighttime or early morning, and Aleph takes care of it. Here are the results. And honestly, they look very realistic. The snow and nighttime edits are especially convincing. Now, the rain effect? I'd say it's not perfect. It doesn't really follow physics, and sometimes looks like the rain is just spreading randomly. But overall, the results are surprisingly good. And when it works, it really works. In extension to this, I want to show you another thing you can do with Aleph. Just like Flux Context, here you can actually generate different camera angles of the same video clip. It's super simple. I used the video where I had already changed the weather to snowy. You just have to click on Edit with Aleph button. That loads the clip as your reference. From here, you can just type a prompt to change the camera angle. For example, one of the prompts I used was, "Change the camera angle to a high, rear-facing aerial shot above this van." And here's the result from that prompt. Pretty cool, right? If you don't have a specific camera angle in mind, you can simply ask, "Show me a unique camera angle," and Aleph will surprise you with something creative. Just like these results here. I went ahead and generated multiple different camera angles, then stitched them together into a short sequence. Let's watch it. So that was pretty cool, right? With just a single reference video, we were able to create a whole scene in completely different weather. For this workflow, I used Kling, Freepik, and ElevenLabs together to generate the audio. All right, you can also use Aleph to change the outfits. accessories, or even hairstyles of people in your videos. For example, I used this clip as a reference and prompted, "Make the man wear a black t-shirt and the woman wear a floral dress." Here's the result. It followed the prompt pretty well, but you'll notice a bit of wonkiness in his hand because of the fast motion. And honestly, that happens a lot. Runway still struggles when there's too much movement. Here are some more variations I tried. In one, I asked to change the man's hairstyle and beard. It worked. But in one of the outputs, it completely changed his face. On the other hand, the woman stayed consistent across all the edits, which is actually pretty impressive. This is another result where Aleph struggled with outfits. In the reference video, the man is wearing a blazer, and I asked it to change his outfit into a police uniform. It actually started out fine, but the moment his blazer shifted, Aleph created this strange blazer-like effect on his shirt in the generated video. Now, here's something else you can do. You can actually remove a person completely from a video. For example, this is the reference clip of a guy skateboarding. I gave the prompt, "Remove the person completely from the video and keep only the skateboard." And here's the result. Pretty wild, right? It erased the person and kept the skateboard rolling, almost like the guy was never there. However, just so you know, if you look closely, you'll notice there are some missing details compared to the original clip. But other than that, it's still really impressive what Aleph can pull off. Here's another example. I prompted Aleph to remove the man on the right, and it did that very easily. That shows Runway can actually understand prompts really well, but sometimes it makes changes you didn't ask for. In this case, it also altered the glass and the handle of the jug, even though my only prompt was to erase the man. Similarly, you can remove the entire background and replace it with something else. For example, I use the prompt, "Replace the background with a green screen," and these are the results I got. I also experimented with hairstyles just to see how well Aleph can understand them. Here are a few generations where I tried multiple different hairstyles and beards on this man, and I have to say, Runway really impressed me with these results. The edits look natural, and most of them followed the prompt surprisingly well. Now let's check out some of the fun tests I did. In this first one, I turned a tennis ball into a fireball. The physics were a little off, but overall it looked good. And here's the nighttime version. Next, I transformed the ball into a sphere of smoke and lightning and then into a fishbowl. Both of these came out really cool. I also tried something silly, swapping a pistol for a banana, but Aleph failed on that every single time. On the other hand, when I prompted for a flood on the floor, it was amazing. In one variation, the flood even came from behind the characters, which looked pretty impressive. I tested it with animals too, but the quality wasn't great. For example, the dog here looks very unrealistic, especially with the fur. And finally, I changed the mountain view into a cityscape, and even into Mount Fuji. And those came out quite solid. So that wraps up today's breakdown of Runway Aleph. Honestly, this tool is only scratching the surface of what's coming with AI video. I'll be testing crazier ideas next, so drop your thoughts in the comments. And if you're new here, hit subscribe so you don't miss the experiments I've got lined up.